two seismic surveys assessing the oil and gas potential of Palawan's east and northwest basins are now completed. The Philippine Energy Department says the surveys, conducted by Israeli firm Ratio Petroleum and the exploration arm of state-owned PNOC, underscore the agency's commitment to pursuing high-impact activities that will support inclusive economic growth. Data processing and analysis from the activities are expected to take at least 1.5 years.
Big and small companies in the Philippines urged to embrace technology to improve their business processes and stay competitive. Jackie Pascual tells us more in this report.
Businesses in the Philippines are urged to innovate and go digital in order to survive the changing trends in technology. At the G Summit 2024, organizers said adapting to the new shift is a must as it will not only help the company, but customers as well. By utilizing technology in business processes like in payments, customer service, and more, they say innovation overall will benefit the economy.
It's how we are going to survive in the digital age. It's impossible to not digitalize ourselves and really try to look to the future for the innovation.
Top companies also shared their partnerships with other firms and their new programs of innovation, which proved to be a success.
Provide Philippine Airlines with real-time, comprehensive travel intelligence to understand, predict, and personalize sales, service, and end-to-end customer experience.
Innovation should be designed with the end user in mind, aiming to solve a problem, a pain point, maybe simplify a task, and essentially improve overall well-being.
But can small businesses afford innovation? Organizers say yes, as entrepreneurs can also collaborate or partner with other companies.
As much as big companies need the innovation and the talent and the fast moving of the small company needs the big company, if nothing else, to plug into their ecosystem, to plug into their technology, and to potentially be a potential acquirer.
How the power of collaborating across these connections is really able to help organizations through greater success, and also how technology, when added into this ecosystem of collaboration, is really able to elevate the whole dynamic.
Summit organizers urge companies to also implement cybersecurity measures as part of innovative practices, as changing technology also brings more threats of cyber attacks. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Talks to restore supply chains and improve economic ties between the world's two largest economies dominate a trade forum in New York. During the U.S.-China Economic and Trade Cooperation Forum, a Chinese business delegation stressed the importance of strengthening mutual cooperation. According to Jonathan Webb, the CEO of American firm Packable, continuous cooperation between Washington and Beijing will benefit global supply chains. For his part, Ren Hongbin, the chairman of the China Council for the Promotion of International Trade, said the two nations are more alike than different.
The common interests between China and the U.S. are increasing instead of decreasing. Whether in traditional areas like trade and agriculture, or emerging areas like climate change and artificial intelligence, companies of both countries have shared interests and broad cooperation prospects.
SpaceX reportedly in talks to land and recover one of its Starship rockets off Australia's coast, which could mark a possible first step towards a bigger presence for the Elon Musk firm in the region. More in this report.
SpaceX could soon be landing its rockets near Australia. Reuters sources say Elon Musk's firm is in talks to bring one of its giant starships down just off the coast. That follows a June test, which saw one of the rockets conduct a controlled splashdown in the Indian Ocean. It also comes as the US and Australia step up their security ties in a bid to counter China. Going ahead will require Washington to relax strict controls on the overseas use of the sophisticated technologies in the rockets, according to the sources. The plan would see a Starship blast off from Texas, land in the sea off Australia, and then be towed ashore for recovery and reuse. That could reportedly be the first phase of a more ambitious plan that would see the rockets take off from or land on Australian soil. Starships are designed to be fully reusable and could have applications besides launching satellites and astronauts. The US Air Force is examining whether they could be used to deliver cargo to the far side of the world in just 90 minutes. SpaceX has also been researching the idea, funded by a Pentagon grant. US budget documents suggest it will start working on a prototype next year. Some at the Pentagon reportedly viewed the June landing in the Indian Ocean as a key step towards the capability.